Hello, Malty, misrepresenting maleficent, malfeasance. Thank you, Kirkes, for that awkward malt mention. I'm Ralfy in the Bothy, Ralfy Review 804 Extras, which is a follow-up to whiskey reviews that I do when I add a little bit more perspective, a little bit more information, a little bit more knowledge and experience that I've gained over the years to help you gain your experience and your knowledge faster. As always, it is purely a perspective, purely an opinion, and that is important for you to keep in mind. I am not claiming in any way to be expert. And to be honest, I find it very interesting that many people are now paying more attention to an opinion than to an expertise. And that happens out there. Things are changing so much. And I can tell you right now, by and large, that dramatic change in the whole world of whiskey commerce is going to continue significantly. Very interesting times ahead. So, a warning to all distillers, put on your seatbelt. Anyway, fingers crossed, those distillers who look after their number one priority, which is quality for customers. And, you know, fair enough, charge what you're going to charge, but make sure it's not too exorbitant. And make sure that there's a golden triangle of customer, quality product, accessible cost, profit for producer. The golden triangle, very important. And it's not just my opinion, it is an economic fact which unfortunately tends to get manipulated a bit by misdirected professionals. Anyway, I'm going to tell you the tale of two Beaumores. And this all ties in with a video I just recently basically gassing off, right, giving a bit of a rant and complaining that discounted whiskies in supermarkets in the UK were causing me concern, which didn't stop me buying them, by the way, which, yeah, it makes me a hypocrite, and I admit it. Hands up. But I wanted to get my bearings on this. That's why I went in and I spent in the supermarket and I got my discounted malts. And this is the one I bought, the Beaumore 12-year-old, and frankly, I wasn't that impressed with it. It was good enough to review, but it was a basic 80 I gave it. You know, the most basic mark I can give, apart from just not reviewing it at all. And I think some distillers would prefer I didn't review than give a basic 80, but there we go. But I compared it to the 15-year-old, which is twice the price. When this isn't discount, this is more than twice the price. But it's a far superior version of Beaumore. So if you want to experience Beaumore, I can tell you, if you start with this, you're not going to have a very positive experience. You will have a professionally competent experience for the category. But it's not going to set your ship on fire. Put it this way. The 15-year-old is far superior. It's, in my opinion, although it's got colour added to it, it's got more natural colour from casks in the first place because it's been part of the whiskey's been matured in fresh sherry casks. So it's got more out of the wood and more of the previous content. It's got more energy, it's got more vitality. It's got simply get more range of flavour. It's a far superior experience, this one, to that one. That's my opinion. It's also bottled at a slightly higher strength. This is 43%. This is 40%. My goodness, if they took this and bottled at 46% unchill filtered, it'd be absolute nectar of the gods. But this is a corporation that owns it. So you've got more distance between the decision makers and the customers because of the bureaucratic structure of such organisations. And I don't mean that as a criticism, I mean it as a fact. It's the nature of organisations. I studied it at college. But there's something else about this that, although at times there's more comments coming into my videos that I can than I can deal with. I do scan over the comments, and one really jumped out, and I thought it was an important comment because it was pivotal to the opinion that I gave in my extras. And it was from Barry, and Barry says he basically doesn't get this. He's been drinking blends for ages and recently getting into malts and has a limited budget and can only afford to buy half decent malts when on offer. Now, there's a lot of people in Barry's situation, and to be honest, it's all very well for me. I'm in a very privileged position. And to be honest, I kind of shouldn't lose sight of that fact. I can, being in Britain, I can get access to discounted whiskey, but importantly, the range of whiskies available to me and the fact that with the advertising and the Patreon support from my Patreon channel, I have a self-funding hobby here, means that I've got a good budget for buying whiskies and for sharing my knowledge and experience. So I really am spoiled. I could go out and spend over £100 on a bottle of single malt, and sometimes I do that. Although, see this £1,000 a bottle nonsense, forget it, I'm not going there. No whiskey's worth that. But sometimes with the age or the particular quality, yeah, some whiskies are worth over £100 because they really are special. They're the sort of whiskies that you smell and taste. The bottle lasts you several months. It could last you years even if you put the inert gas in it. I've had a bottle of Lafroy 15 years it's been open. It's still fresh as a daisy because I use the gas. The private preserve, it's called. It's wine preserver gas. It's by far the most effective way of sealing off liquor from oxidisation. But it's, I mean, it's all very... I'm in luxury land, and Barry, it was very, very timely comment. It says, it's fine for you, Ralph, but what about folk who are on a budget? Right, here's my advice. If you're in a real tight budget, one, buy less. Spend a little bit more on a bottle, but buy less. Because you will have a single malt experience, but you may find over time that you get frustrated with that experience because the lack of quality that's in the bottle. In fact, I would say, if you're in the UK in particular, go into Lidl and Aldi, get your timing right, buy these 25-year-old single malts for 40 quid that they occasionally do, that they don't taste their age, but they're damn fine single malts. Very good stuff. And the blends, the Queen Margot, 8-year-old, 3-year-old. I've reviewed it. It's one of the most impressive whiskies I've reviewed this year. And it was my cheapest. So, you know, I can make these discoveries too, and it's important I review these whiskies to bring them to the attention of people who are on a budget. But Barry goes on that, you know, he mentions the purchases, Bunahabhain 12, Lafroig 10, Talisker 10, Glenmorangie. These are the whiskies, and goodness knows that they have age statements, and I applaud them for that. But part of me is bothered that in the UK anyway, the home of Scotch whisky, they're actually subsidising your what they call your second entry level malts by what they're increasingly charging for more of the older stuff and the better bottled stuff, higher strength, unchill filtered, natural colour. And what I would recommend to folk who are in Barry's situation, if you're on a budget, fair dues, go to the supermarket, but don't forget to look for the affordably, slightly more expensive, but affordable other whiskies out there, like Deanston 12-year-old, Arran 10-year-old, Arran 12-year-old, Kilkerran. If you're quick, get in with the order, because these whiskies sell out. They're really, really well priced. And I tell you, once you taste and smell and spend time time with these craft style integrity malts. You'll soon lose your appetite for what can be essentially over time, not initially, because you need the experience to get your bearings, but what over time can start to be seen as a false economy. I'm just sharing my perspective here. But it not just it's not just Barry, there's others commented that they're not in the UK, they're in Canada and Australia and in other countries where there's ridiculous import taxes and, you know, all the distributors are making their cut along the line. So that ends up whiskey can become hellishly expensive. And guys, my advice is simple. Don't wait for the next bottle of scotch to arrive. Look at what you've got locally. And it's not necessarily going to be whiskey, it could be rum. I mean, one of the finest spirits I tasted when I was in Australia was Green Spot rum. And it's Fijian rum. And it was seriously good. I bought a bottle, by the way, finish off with a wee story. When I was in Australia, I bought a bottle of Old Outback Australian whiskey. And it had a coin on the front. It was a square bottle. It came in a wooden box. And then this is many years ago. And I thought, I've never seen an Australian whiskey like this. This looks the real, looks the part. And it kind of red bark wood and all the rest of it, that sort of thing going on. And I opened it, and what I was tasting and smelling was some pretty raw spirit, which seemed, in my opinion, to have been flavoured with Manuka honey. Actually flavoured. I wish I'd kept it shut. I really do. I just popped it into auction as a novelty years later. But hey ho, you need to try and taste before you get your bearings. But there we go. I hope you don't mind, Barry, me mentioning your comments. But I think it's important because you were one of the most articulate people in the comment section making that point. And to be honest, I stand corrected in that I mustn't lose sight of the fact that it's all right for me having the great budget and great access. Lucky me. But many, many people don't, but they still want to be informed and educated and all the rest of it by my content. So thank you very much, folks. I have now given you my advice on the matter. I hope you find it useful. And I think one more piece of advice before I go is that if you are really into your whiskey and you're looking for the perfect ratio of the price you pay to the quality you're getting and you're on a budget, one of the best things is to have a local online regional forum where you are, where you connect with other whiskey people where you are in the world, because the fact is that you may be geographically quite far apart. But, for example, if you build up a good rapport in your little whiskey group, your online virtual whiskey club... Oops. Oh, yeah, that's getting awful rocky. I think my clothes peg has come unstuck from my side of the barrel. I must stick it back in, and again, because I don't want bottles falling over. Anyway, what I recommend is you have your virtual whiskey clubs, because someone is going to have a relative come over and visit from the UK. They're going to build a big bottle of something really, really nice. And if you've got a good rapport, you could even divide it into little bottles and send your mates a sample by post. Bottles by post tend to get intercepted and destroyed because it's alcohol, and alcohol is evil, etc. Except for when they're getting the taxes off and making money. So there's obsessive control of alcohol. It's an obsession, and it's basically lazy governance. Lazy governance. And a fear of alcohol, because alcohol starts revolutions and social disruptions without a, that's a fact. And as soon as people get pissed off with governments, they start to reach for alcohol. And that's where it kicks off. But if you have the virtual club, the communication of say, a new bottle of spirits coming into your state or your area in Australia, New Zealand, America, Canada, Mexico, Brazil, Russia, wherever, you can share that local information that other folk are oblivious to, and it may give you a strategic advantage, particularly as you share opinions with your virtual whiskey club, give you strategic advantage on getting better value and not making financial mistakes, and having a good crack while you're at it with your virtual mates. Hey, there you go. I'm Ralfy. That'll do for now. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. And we'll see you shortly for another Ralfy review, where I'll be reviewing a different type of whiskey to this. Very different. But one that I would definitely recommend at this time of year, and is available, accessible, affordable, although it comes from a smaller distillery. So it's all relative. It is all relative. I'm aware of that. Bear with me, malt mates, and thank you. Bye.